Hi friends, this is Manjusha Swaro from Nirmal TSWRDC, and today I'm going to discuss about an important topic with you, and this topic, it will be very useful for you in your daily life. And actually here my topic is how Consumer Protection Act 2018 prevents the unfair trade practices. And friends, I think you are hearing a lot about this Consumer Protection Bill 2018 in the newspapers and the magazines and so on. But actually, what is this Consumer Protection Bill 2018? Yes, friends, this Consumer Protection Bill 2018 is a bill introduced to replace the Consumer Protection Act 1986. And if this bill becomes the act, that means if it comes into the force, how this act prevents the unfair trade practices is the main point here. And friends, before going to the topic that is the Consumer Protection Act 2018, let me introduce you what is Consumer Protection Act 1986. So friends, here on the slide we have the Consumer Protection Act 1986, and yes friends, this Consumer Protection Act 1986 is an act enacted by the Indian Parliament on 24th December 1986 to protect and promote the consumer interests and the consumer rights. And this Consumer Protection Act 1986, it is applicable to all the states in India except the Jammu and Kashmir. And okay friends, this Consumer Protection Act 1986 is enacted, and for what purpose is it enacted, and for what purpose? So let us know for what purpose it is enacted. Here, this Act 1986, it was enacted to protect the consumer interests and to protect the consumer rights, to redress the consumer grievances and to prevent the unfair trade practices. For this purpose, the Consumer Protection Act 1986 is enacted. And friends, here all we are talking about the consumer and his rights and his interests. First of all, who is a consumer? So for this, the Consumer Protection Act 1986, it defined consumer as, here, a person who buys a product or avails any service for a compensation for his own personal use is known as a consumer. And friends, we have another thing here, that a person who buys a product for resale or for further manufacture purpose is not considered as a consumer. For example, friends, we are the consumers here because from starting to the end of the day, we are consuming a lot of things. That means we are going to shop and we are purchasing the rice which we want to eat, and we are purchasing the vegetables. For what purpose? For our own personal use purpose. So here we are the consumers, and the traders and the manufacturers, they will also purchase the products. That means for what purpose they will purchase? For further resale purpose or further manufacture purpose. So here these traders and the manufacturers, they are not considered as the consumers. And here the consumers are buying the product by paying the money and for the consideration. So here the consumers have the right to question about that product, and he has all the rights on that product. So here for this, the Consumer Protection Act provided six basic rights for the consumer. So now we have the rights on the slide, friends. Here the first right is the right to safety, the right to information, the right to choose, the right to be heard, the right to seek redressal, and the final, the right to consumer education. Here we are the consumer, friends. So we have the right to know all about it, and we have to know it. So now let us know about these consumer rights in detail. Okay, here the first right is the right to safety. That means the Consumer Protection Act, it provides the right to safety. Here the consumer have a right to be protected against the marketing and the selling of the hazardous goods which are harmful to our health, our life and our property too. That means, for example friends, medicines. Some pharmaceutical industries, they will produce defaulted medicines, that means duplicated medicines. It may cause harm to our life, our health. So here we have a right to protect from that hazardous goods or the hazardous product. So in this way, the Consumer Protection Act 1986, it provides a right to safety. And the next is the right to information. And here on the slide, we have the right to information. Here, friends, the consumer have a right to be informed about the quality, quantity, and the standard, purity, and all about the product to protect himself against the unfair trade practices committed by the traders and the manufacturers. Here, friends, for example, if we go to a shop to buy a phone or a mobile, here we have a right to know all about that phone before we are buying the phone. That means if we want to buy a phone, what information we want to get? First of all, we will check the phone that if its camera is working proper or not, and what is the RAM of that phone, and what is the ROM of that phone, and what is the model of that phone. So all this information we want to know. Here, this Consumer Protection Act 1986, it provided us a right to know information about all the product before buying that product. So here now, friends, and we have the next right, and this is the right to choose. Here, friends, the consumer have a right to choose. That means if we go to markets, there we find a lot of goods and a number of goods, and they are of different brands and different companies and so on. So here a consumer has a right to choose what he want and which he suits best. That means here there is no force to a consumer to choose that product or to choose this product. Here it is his own intention to select the product which he want. So the Consumer Protection Act 1986 provides this right to choose for the consumers. And the next is the right to be heard. Here, if a consumer suffered a loss, he has a right to be heard. That means he can file a complaint at the courts, that means the consumer courts, and his complaint is heard at the consumer courts. And here he also given a chance to speak what he want and what is going on. And here if the consumer he didn't speak anything, nothing change will be takes place, and they all will be going on in the same way. So here the consumers should speak about what loss he has suffered, and he has to speak up. So here this right, it is also provided by the Act 1986. And the next right, we have the right to seek redressal. Here the consumers have the right to seek redressal against the unfair trade practices and for the losses suffered by them. That means, friends, you are a consumer and you suffered a loss. That means the trader, he cheated you in some ways by selling product for high prices or in some way. So here you have a right to seek redressal. That means you have a right to go to the consumer courts, and there you can file a complaint, and there you can seek redressal. That means there you will be paid a compensation for a loss suffered by you. And this is the right provided by the Act 1986. And friends, the next is the right to education. Here, the Consumer Protection Act 1986, it also provides a right to consumer education, because a lot of consumers, they are unaware of their rights. That means, I think some people, they don't know that this Consumer Protection Act is there to protect the consumer rights and to seek their grievances. So friends, to bring the awareness in the consumers about their rights and so on, this the Act 1986, it provided the right to education. Here it also celebrates the March 15 every year as the World Consumer Rights Day to bring the awareness in the consumers. So friends, these are the rights provided by the Consumer Protection Act 1986. And now let us go to the Consumer Protection Councils. Here, this act, that means the Consumer Protection Act 1986, it also established the Consumer Protection Councils. And these councils, they are established at three levels, at the central level, at the state level, and at the district level. Here, the central level is known as the Central Consumer Protection Council. And the state level is known as the State Consumer Protection Council, and the district level is known as the District Consumer Protection Council. Here, here for all this council, a chairman is headed for this to see or look over all these councils. So this chairman, who is this chairman to this councils, is the minister in charge of the consumer affairs at the central level, is appointed as the chairman at the Central Consumer Protection Council. And the minister in charge of consumer affairs at the state level is appointed as the chairman at the State Consumer Protection Council. And here at the District Consumer Protection Council, the district collector is appointed as the chairman at the District Consumer Protection Council. So friends, these are the councils provided by the Consumer Protection Act 1986, and these councils, it mainly works to protect and promote the consumer rights and their interests, friends. Okay, this is about the Consumer Protection Councils, and this act, it also provided the Consumer Dispute Redressal Agencies or commissions. That means this is a three-tier judiciary system, and it is established at three levels: at the district level, at the state level, and at the national level. Here, at the district level, it is known as the district forum, and at the state level, it is known as the state commission, and at the national level, it is known as the national commission. Here, these commissions are headed by the president. That means here this president is appointed to look after these commissions. Okay, and these district forum, here at the district forum, the president, who is the president here? The judge of the district judge. District judge is appointed as the president at the district forum. And the judge of the high court is appointed as the president at the state commission. And the judge of the Supreme Court is appointed as the president at the national commission. So, here these commissions, it works for the consumer dispute redressal. That means if any consumer suffers loss, they can file complaint there, and his complaint is checked at the consumer courts, and his problem is solved there, and he gets and he seeks a redress there. And the next is, and friends, let me share an example with you. Here the case, we have a case in commerce, we have, that is a competition school of nursing versus Dalbir Singh. In this case, the petitioner, that means the Dalbir Singh, he want to pursue nursing course. So for taking into admission into this nursing school, he was asked to pay the 2 years fee in the first 6 months. So he agreed for that, and he paid the fee of 2 years in the first 6 months. And in some situation, in the midway of the course, he left that school and he asked to refund his fee which he was paid extra. But this school, it refused to pay the fee which is extra. So he filed this petitioner, that means Dalbir Singh, he filed a complaint at the consumer courts, and for this the national commission, it held that any educational institute should not take the fee before the course is over, or it should not collect more fee from the students. And in case if it is collected and in the midway the students drops, the school should refund the extra fee which was paid. So in this way, this consumer courts works to redress the grievances of the consumers here. And next, let us go to the Consumer Protection Bill 2018 here. And friends, you may get a doubt that already this Consumer Protection Act 1986 is enacted and it is in existence and it's working a lot for the consumer dispute redressal. Then for what purpose this Consumer Protection Bill 2018 is introduced? For this, we have a strong reason, friends. Let me explain you what is that reason. Here, friends, from many years, there are a lot of challenges to implement the act. And this Consumer Protection Act 1986, it is working to an extent but the consumer cases, that means the cases which are pending, is very high, and the time taken to solve that cases is also long. So in this way, the Act 1986, it failed to address these pending cases. And another thing we have, that this act, that which is the 1986 act, it didn't address the unfair contracts and the emergence in the global supply chains and the rise in the international trade and the rapid growth in the e-commerce have led a new delivery systems of goods and services, and it also brought new opportunities and options to the consumers. So not only the new opportunities and options, it also brought a new type of unfair trade practices and also a lot of unethical business practices. So this Consumer Protection Act 1986, it failed to address these unfair trade practices which are committed by the e-commerce traders. So to address this, the Consumer Protection Act was enacted, and this Consumer Protection Bill 2018 was introduced to Lok Sabha on 5th January 2018 by Ram Vilas Paswan. And to replace the Consumer Protection Act 1986 and to address the shortcomings in it and to prevent the unfair trade practices. Okay friends, here we talked that this Consumer Protection Bill 2018 is introduced to prevent the unfair trade practices. Then what are the unfair trade practices first of all? So for this, let us go to the next slide to see what are the unfair trade practices. Yes friend, here we are the consumers, and we consume a lot of things from starting to till the end of the day. And here in this way, the traders and the manufacturers, they are cheating these consumers in a lot of ways by selling faulty goods or imperfect goods and selling products for high prices and not providing the exact information about the products and giving the misleading advertisements. In this way, the consumers are cheated in many ways by the traders and the manufacturers. And if we look into the slide friends, here we have Maggi here. This Maggi was banned because it committed misleading advertisement and it gave misleading advertisement. So for this purpose, the consumer court banned it in 2015. And as we look into the slide, the next is here the water bottle. It may cost 20 rupees or 30 rupees, but it was sold to 50 rupees. That means this water bottle, it was sold to high prices. Here the trader is committed unfair trade practices. And the next here is the foodstuff friends. As we look them in advertisements, we will think that when we have to eat them and when we have to purchase them. But if we look into them in reality, there will be nothing as we felt. So in this way, the consumers are cheated a lot of ways by the traders. And these are the unfair trade practices, and it was provided by the Consumer Protection Act 1986. But this bill 2018, it brought new more three unfair trade practices into the slide. So let us see what are they. Here, these are the unfair trade practices according to the Consumer Protection Bill 2018. And here the three are not issuing the bill or the receipt after selling the goods. And the next is not accepting the goods which are returned in 30 days and disclosing the personal information to others without the permission of the consumer here. So these three are the new unfair trade practices included into the list of the unfair trade practices by the Consumer Protection Bill 2018. Okay friends, these are the unfair trade practices, and we just now talked, this bill is introduced to prevent the unfair trade practices. And how this bill, it prevents unfair trade practices? So let us know now how it prevents unfair trade practices. And friends, to prevent these unfair trade practices, the bill brought new provisions to the account here. And the new provisions here on the slide, we have it. So friends, the first is the regulator and the product liability, unfair contracts, mediation cells, liability of the celebrity endorsers and penalties, e-commerce and filing complaints electronically. Here friends, these are the new provisions brought forward by the Consumer Protection Bill 2018 to prevent the unfair trade practices. Now friends, let us know about this in detail, how it prevents the unfair trade practices. Okay friends, first here we have the regulator. The Bill 2018, it provides an establishment for the regulator to prevent the unfair trade practices. So first of all, what is the regulator here? Okay friends, this regulator is an executive agency to regulate the matters relating to the violating of the rights of a consumer, and it also promote and protect and enforce the rights of a consumers here. And this bill, it introduced the regulator as the Central Consumer Protection Authority, that means the CCPA. And now let us see what is the role of this CCPA to prevent the unfair trade practices. Here friends, this CCPA, it has an investigation cell, and it receives the consumer complaints and it investigates into the consumer complaints which are filed by the consumers. And this CCPA, that means the regulator, has also the powers to issue the safety notices for goods and services, and it also gives the orders or passes the orders to recall the goods and prevent the unfair trade practices. And it also has a right to ban the goods which are defective and which are harmful to the consumers. And it also have a right to reimburse the price paid for the defective goods. And this CCPA, it also have a power to impose the penalties on the misleading advertisements. And here friends, according to the Consumer Protection Act 1986, we have a right to seek redressal. That means the consumers go to the consumer courts and file a complaint and seek redressal. But when after the loss is suffered and after the unfair trade practice is committed, but there is no such regulator to prevent the unfair trade practices before they are occurred. But this bill 2018, it provides the regulator to prevent the unfair trade practices, and it has an investigation cell and it looks into all the issues which may lead to the violating of the rights of the consumers and prevent them before they are occurs. And friends, this is the role of the CCPA to prevent the unfair trade practices. And according to the Consumer Protection Act 1986, there is no provision for this regulator, but this bill 2018, it provided a establishment for this CCPA. And next friends, the product liability. Here for this also there is no provision in the 1986 Act, but 2018 bill, it brought a new provision for product liabilities. And here, what is this product liability mean? Yes friends, this product liability is the responsibility of the product manufacturers or the product sellers to compensate for any harm caused to the consumers and for the defective good manufactured by them. Here friends, for example, we went to an LED shop and we LED TV shop and we bought an LED TV, and they gave warranty for 1 year, but this LED TV, it stopped working within a month. That means it have a defect in it. Here the manufacturer and the trader is made responsible to pay for the compensation for this defect occurred in the LED TV. In this way, if the traders and the manufacturers, are made liable, the unfair trade practices may be not committed. And here, unfair contracts. These unfair contracts are a contract which causes significant change in the rights of a consumer is known as the unfair contracts. And the next is the mediation cell. This mediation cell is an alternative dispute redressal mechanism. It is a neutral problem solver specially educated and trained to settle the matters of the consumer disputes in a very timely manner. And the next is liability for the celebrity endorses. Here, friends, celebrity endorsement is nothing but the traders and the manufacturers makes advertisements of their products by the this celebrities. And if these celebrities gives any misleading advertisements, here these celebrities also liable for the compensation here. And the penalties here. Here this bill 2018, it brings new provisions for the penalties. And let us see what are the penalties. Here, if a person doesn't comply with the orders issued by the commissions, he is liable for imprisonment, and he may face imprisonment up to 3 years and a fine not less than 25,000. And the next, if the person doesn't comply with the orders issued by the CCPA, that means the regulator, he may face an imprisonment up to 6 months and a fine up to 20 lakhs here. In this way, the fines, the penalties are imposed, and here for misleading advertisements, the penalty is 10 lakhs. And the next is e-commerce. For this e-commerce, there is no provision in the bill according to the Act 1986, but this bill 2018, it brings new provision, and the unfair trade practices committed by the e-commerce are also addressed by this Consumer Protection Bill 2018. And here, okay friends, here all these new provisions are brought to redress the consumer grievances and file, and if any loss suffered, they can file a complaint. But where to file a complaint? For this, a complaint can be filed at the consumer dispute redressal agencies. Okay friends, and who can file a complaint here? That means a consumer who suffered a loss, or the legal representative of this consumer, or any registered organizations can file a complaint. And here, if he files a complaint, he can seek redressal by he can get relief by removal of defective good from the products which are sold, and replacement of the goods which are defective, and repayment of the price which was paid to that defective good. And friends, these are the new provisions provided by the Consumer Protection Bill 2018 to prevent the unfair trade practices and to redress the consumer grievances. And okay friends, here we have the Consumer Protection Act 2018, and it redresses our grievances. So friends, if you suffer any loss, go to the consumer courts and file a complaint and seek redressal. Here we have no more loss. Okay friends, and I finally thank our secretary Praveen Kumar sir Garu for giving me this golden opportunity, and I also thank my parents and my principals and my lecturers, and thank you so much.